Hello students, today we are going to take the two topics, that is the rainbow formation and the atmospheric reflection. First let us take the rainbow. Now rainbow you might have seen during the rainy season when there is a shower of rains and the sunlight is there, sun comes outside, then you might have sometimes observed the rainbow. Now what is rainbow? A rainbow is a natural spectrum appearing in the sky after a rain shower. Now how it is caused? It is caused by dispersion of sunlight by tiny water droplets present in the atmosphere. You know the meaning of dispersion. The dispersion is the splitting of white light into seven colors. A rainbow is always formed in a direction opposite to that of the sun. That means the sun should always be in your backside and the rainbow will be seen in the front. So the water droplet acts like small prism, which disperse the sunlight into seven color. So this is a water droplet. It disperses the, when the ray of sunlight enters the water droplet, a dispersion takes place here. And due to dispersion, it splits into seven color that we see, that is violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. So dispersion takes place here. And at this side, the internal reflection takes place. Internal reflection takes place and it is moved in the backward direction. And when it comes outside the water droplets, again the refraction takes place. So there are three phenomena here, that is the dispersion, internal reflection and refraction. So the water droplet acts like small prism. They refract and disperse the sunlight here. They refract and disperse the sunlight, then reflect it internally here, and reflect it again when it comes outside the water droplet. Due to the dispersion of light and internal reflection, different colors reaches the observer's eyes, that is seen as rainbow. Light coming from the stars and entering the Earth atmosphere passes from rarer medium to the denser layer of the atmosphere. Therefore, it suffers multiple refraction before reaching the Earth. So, this multiple refraction is due to the atmospheric refraction. Now, let us study the phenomenon based on the atmospheric refraction. The first phenomenon is star seems higher than they actually are. Now this is the position of the star here, and the star light enters the Earth atmosphere and suffers the refraction here. The star light on entering the Earth atmosphere undergoes refraction continuously before it reaches the Earth. Continuous refraction is taking place before it reaches to the Earth. The atmospheric refraction occurs in a medium of gradually changing refractive index. Since the atmosphere bends starlight towards the normal, the apparent position of the star, this is the apparent position of the star here. This is the actual position, this is the apparent position of the star. Since the atmosphere bends starlight towards the normal, the apparent position of the star is slightly different. Slightly different, as you can see, it is slightly higher than its actual position. The star appears slightly higher above than its actual position, and this is due to the refraction. Now let us take the second phenomenon, which is based on atmospheric reflection, the second, that is twinkling of star. Now when the light coming from the star enters the Earth atmosphere, it undergoes refraction. When ray of light enters the Earth atmosphere, it undergoes atmospheric refraction due to the various optical density layer. Now the atmosphere is made up of different layers, and the different layers have different optical densities at the various altitudes. So the atmosphere is continuously changing. This atmosphere is not fixed, it is continuously changing, due to which the optical density of air at different level is also changing. So the continuously changing atmosphere reflects the light from the star coming from the star with a different amount. When more light bent towards us, then the star appears bright, and when the lesser amount of light and bent towards us, then the star appears dim. So this bright and dim effect is causing the twinkling of stars. Now the question arises in the mind that the star twinkles whereas the planets do not. Why the star twinkles whereas the planets do not? And now I am going to explain the reason behind it. The star is very, very far from us. So they appear as a point source of light. So the continuously changing atmosphere is able to cause variation in the light coming from a point size source star. This is very far, so it is a point size source star, source of light. So the continuously changing atmosphere is able to cause variation in the light coming from a point size source due to the reflection. Because of this, the star appears to twinkles. On the other hand, the planets appears to quite big to us because they are much nearer to the Earth. So they are considered as the collection of many point sources of light. They are considered to be collection of very large number of point sources of light. So the total variation in the amount of light entering our eye from all the individual point size source will average out to zero, thereby nullifying the twinkling effect. To explain it better, we can say there is a collection of many point source size, a large number of point source size source of light. So some of them will be producing the brighter effect and some of them will be producing the dim effect, so nullifying the twinkling effect. That is why the planets do not twinkle whereas the stars twinkles. Now let us take the third phenomenon based on atmospheric reflection, that is advanced sunrise and delayed sunset. The sun is visible to us before about 2 minutes before the actual sunrise and about 2 minutes delay after the actual sunset because of the atmospheric reflection. Now when the sun is slightly below the horizon, you can see the sun is below the horizon, then the sunlight which is coming from less dense air to more dense air bends downward due to the atmospheric reflection. Because of this atmospheric reflection, the sun appears to be a slightly higher position than the horizon when actually it is below the horizon. So that is why about 2 minutes, the sun is visible to us about 2 minutes before the actual sunrise. It is also due to the same reason, that is same atmospheric reflection. We can see the sun for about 2 minutes even more than the sun actual sunset is taking place. So due to the atmospheric reflection, the sun can be seen 2 minutes after the actual sunset has taken place. The apparent flattening of the sun disk at sunrise and sunset is also due to the atmospheric reflection.